Hello, dear students. I'm Assistant Professor Vishali Ahir. And in the last session of Microbiology Part 1, we have already started with the nucleic acids, in which we have studied the different terms, what are nucleotides, what are nucleosides, then the various components like sugars, phosphoric acid group, as well as the nitrogen bases. So, in our today's session, we are going to see the first type of nucleic acid, which is deoxyribonucleic acid or a DNA. Now, DNA is a double-stranded helical structure where each strand is a polydeoxyribonucleotide joined by phosphodiester linkages, where DNA is a genetic material present in the most of the organisms, and every living organisms generally they contains DNA. And this genetic material is transferred from one generation to the another generations. The structure of this DNA was proposed by Watson and Crick in the year 1953. And this structure was revealed by using the X-ray crystallographic photographs of Rosalind Franklin. And this DNA, it may exist in the various forms like A, B and D. If we consider through the various experiments, it was concluded that the DNA is the genetic material which is present in the nucleus of the cell. If we consider about the human DNA, it contains near about 3 million deoxyribonucleotide residue and contains near about 25,000 genes. The genes are the fragments of the DNA, and these genes carries the codes for the protein production. If we study the replication, translation and transcription process, in the first process, which is transcription, in which DNA, it is the process of formation of mRNA from the DNA molecule, and from this mRNA the protein synthesis is carried out. So these genes are the codes of protein production. See, here you can see the exact structure or the strands of the polynucleotides. Now here, if we consider only a single nucleotide, a pentose sugar, a phosphate group, as well as a nitrogen base, such type of nucleotides are joined to each other and a long polynucleotide chain is formed. And one polynucleotide chain is joined to the another polynucleotide chain, which consists of a complementary sequence with the help of hydrogen bonds. Generally, in the Watson and Crick DNA model, it has two long polynucleotide strands which are coiled around imaginary central axis and forms a double helical structure. The diameter of DNA is around 20 armstrong and a distance between two successive bases. This distance between two successive bases is near about 3.4 armstrong unit. So this is the two strands of polynucleotide sequence which joins to each other to form a double-stranded structure of DNA. As we have discussed that the DNA is made up of two strands of polynucleotide. The sister strand of DNA molecule runs in the opposite direction or the anti-parallel direction, and they are joined by the bases. Each base is paired with the specific pattern. Means a adenine is always joined to the thymine group and a guanine always paired with the cytosine. That is, each purine is paired with the pyrimidine group. Whereas each sister strand has the complementary sequence to the parental strand, which are not identical. And these bases are joined with the help of hydrogen bonds. Where this joining, here you can see adenine is joined to the thymine group with the double bond. Whereas guanine and cytosine bonding is with the help of triple bonds. Here are the structures of purines and pyrimidines. First, we will study the structure of purines. Now, purine includes adenine and guanine in case of both DNA and RNA. So, here is the structure of adenine and guanine. And the pyrimidine group includes thymine. This is the structure of thymine and cytosine. So, these are the nitrogen bases which are present inside the DNA molecule. Here you can see the Watson and Crick base pairing. Here, a sugar molecule, a thymine group is joined to the adenine with the help of double hydrogen bond. These are the hydrogen bonds which helps the binding of thymine group to the adenine. Similarly, a cytosine sugar or the cytosine is joined to the guanine with the help of three hydrogen bonds. See, these are the three hydrogen bonds with the help of which, and similarly, these bases are joined to each other in each polynucleotide sequences. See, here you can see the double helix molecule or the structure of DNA which was proposed by Watson and Crick in the year 1953. These both the strands are coiled in a right-handed helical fashion, in which two strands are anti-parallel, where one strand is oriented in 5 prime to 3 prime direction and other strand is in the form of 3 prime to 5 prime direction. Now, basically, if we study the structure of DNA, the structure of DNA can be understood in the three levels. First level is the primary structure. In primary structure, it determines or the refers to the sequence of the nucleotide residue. How does nucleotides are bind to each other? That sequence is determined in the primary structure. Then the second level includes the secondary structure of DNA. Now, the secondary structure of DNA is studied depending on the helix pattern formed in the DNA strand. Depending on the helical pattern formed in the DNA strand, the secondary structure of DNA can be determined. And the tertiary structure refers to the three-dimensional shape arises from the supercoiling where double helix is being twisted into compact shape. When the double helix molecule gets twisted and a small compact shape which is three-dimensional is formed, then the tertiary structure of DNA can be determined. Now, how does DNA replication takes place? Now, the DNA carries various informations which are important for the production of proteins in all the organisms. And these information is transferred from one generation to the another generation. So, here the primary structure of DNA is very important. The information is carried in the primary structure of the DNA. And for passing of this information, a new cell or a new DNA generation in the cell is very important. So, the DNA replication is done. Now, how does this DNA replication is done? That we will see. First, each strand of double helix molecule are separated and this serves as a template for the manufacturing of new strand of DNA. And each of the daughter DNA strand one strand forms a parent DNA as well as मतलब यहाँ क्या होता है कि DNA molecule जो double stranded molecule होता है वो double stranded molecule it gets separated and each single strand forms a new double helix molecule by joining the complementary strand. And in this way, the DNA replication takes place. Let's not go in more detail about it. And this is called as super conservative replication. And the production of DNA is carried out with the help of enzyme called as DNA polymerase. And this DNA polymerase catalyzes the addition of deoxyribonucleotide residue to the growing DNA strand. So, this was all about the first type of nucleic acid, which is DNA molecule. In the next lecture, we will study about the second type of nucleic acid, which is RNA molecule. Thank you.